Hey everyone, let's talk about a brand new powerful numerical technique. In the past, we talked about numerical differentiation, but now let's talk about the other fundamental calculus concept, integration. Before we get into what numerical integration is, let's briefly recall what analytical integration is. Analytical integrals are a mathematical technique to get the exact area under a given function between two bounds, denoted here by a and b. This is one of the foundations of calculus and is extremely useful in just about every field imaginable. However, as we talked about earlier in the course, finding this integral can be difficult or sometimes even impossible. Well, this is where numerical integration comes in. Numerical integration is a numerical method used to approximate the value of a definite integral by dividing it into smaller, manageable subintervals and approximating the area under the curve within each subinterval. If we were to imagine the function e to the x, it would look something like this. Then we would divide it up into, let's say, 5 subintervals. And use our numerical integration techniques that we'll learn about in the coming videos to approximate the area of each of these blocks. Some numerical integration techniques that can be used to approximate this area is Simpson's rule, the trapezoid rule, or Gaussian quadratures. Much like our other numerical methods that we've learned about in the past, this technique is useful when dealing with complex functions or when the integrals cannot be evaluated analytically. Numerical integration offers several advantages over analytical integration, with the downside being we give up some accuracy in comparison to our analytical solutions. In general, though, numerical integration allows us to handle complex functions, work with discrete data, and approximate definite integrals that lack analytical solutions. It's a powerful tool that has applications in many fields, such as physics, engineering, and finance. This wraps up our introduction to numerical integration. In the coming videos, we'll be walking through several numerical integration techniques in theory and example videos. So stay tuned to the series to learn more about this incredibly useful numerical method. I hope that this video helped your understanding of what numerical integration is and what it's used for. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.